Amen. Let's get started. Amen. I invited my game changers. I told them I want them to see what this is really about. You know, we're not here putting on no show. I'm not an entertainer. I'm not against entertainment, but I'm not an entertainer. We're here to actually change lives. And when I went in the green room, they had a little statue of Dr. Martin Luther King, and I was just like, wow. To be able to do in this generation what Dr. Martin Luther King did in his generation. I'm like, unbelievable. And I saw Dr. Martin, I never saw my man speak, but his impact, the influence that he left on the world. And that's what I want you to be able to do. I want you to get in your right place. So not only will you be blessed, but I'm telling you, when you get to your right place, then you're going to be able to bless people in the way that God wants you to bless people. Amen? Come on, somebody. I'm excited. Amen. Are we good to go? Are we good to go? Y'all ready? And the Lord gave me this message. Hallelujah. We won't take long tonight. We won't take long. Good. Thank you, Cam. We won't take long. Amen. Then we turned and took our journey into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. As the Lord spake unto me, and we compassed the Mount Seir many days. Watch this, y'all. This is for you. And the Lord spake unto me, saying, you have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn ye northward. DJ, do me a favor. I'm all the way up. Nothing can you cue that for me? Nothing can stop me. Cue that. I'm going to tell you when we're ready for that. Amen. Praise God. We're going all the way up. Nothing can stop. Watch this, guys. I am super excited. Amen. God gave me a word for you. Amen. So the Bible says that there is this group. Amen. And they walking, y'all. They walking and they compasses me. They walk in the mountain and they walk in the mountain. And unfortunately, they walk in the mountain. They going in circles and they're not getting nowhere. Amen. God told me to tell you that there are those of you who are putting forth effort, but you're not getting anywhere. Amen. We talked about it last week. Amen. We talked about 3 weeks ago. We talked about it that you're casting your net on the wrong side, that you're putting forth effort. Amen. But you're putting forth human effort and God wants you to stop.
Right.
And he wants you to join forces with him. Amen. Did you hear what I said? I had to join forces with somebody that knows how to get paperwork done in 24 hours. Like, I'm past the point of acting like I can get it done and when it's paperwork. I'm past trying to fool myself and say, Eric, you can do this. No, you cannot. If it's paperwork, you're going to need to bring somebody in, some backup. Not because you don't know how to do it, but you don't have the spirit to do it. Oh, you got to hear what I'm saying. If somebody called me and they're like, E, I need counseling, I have the spirit to do that. There's a spirit on me that's like, let's go. My wife said, when you go to Atlanta and preach this time, don't do 2 hours. I got the spirit to do 3. But I don't have 30 seconds to do paperwork. Amen. Hear what I'm saying? I don't have 10 seconds for paperwork. As soon as I start doing paperwork, something come, like my emotions and energy, something just come out of me. I don't even know what it is. When my wife started talking about we're going to do spring cleaning, I'm like, spring cleaning? Why are we doing that? We got some paper now. We can't call one of these services and let them come in and do it. She's like, I'm private. Well, I'm not. You go be private. Like, go in the basement while they're upstairs cleaning up. Just stay private. I'm not private. They can clean up. I'll be here. We can leave. They can come. It's like, and so when she starts saying clean up, I just like, my energy is just gone. Amen. But when I speak, the reason why I have someone, because the spirit is with me. And God is telling me to tell some of you that you're working on your relationships, you're trying to get in a relationship, but you're not doing it in the spirit. And so that's why you're not getting a lot of success. Amen. And that's what Tiff is talking. And I messed up bad, but we got to get something where we can get together and we can pray with you guys until you're strong enough to do it on your own. Amen. Some of you are working and you're using man's tips and or like you're going online. You like the 9 ways to. For real, you ain't praying about it. You didn't went to the job interview. You have not prayed about it. You ain't asked God nothing. You ain't asked the Lord to be with you. You just went in the job interview with your resume and was like, this should be enough. You took your degree. You was like, I got my resume, my degree, and my work experiences. I know I got the job, but you didn't take the spirit. You didn't take the spirit with you. And so whenever you go in the flesh, you can't guarantee that you're going to get victory. And so the word of God said that they was walking, like they weren't just chilling. They weren't watching TV, playing video games. They were actually working. They were actually climbing the mountain. They were actually doing it for multiple days, for multiple weeks, for multiple months, for years. They walking around in the desert. And watch what the Lord of the watch what the word of the Lord says. The word of the Lord says, "Then we turn. You have been in this spot on this mountain too long." Amen. I want to help you real quick. We about to go there, but I want you to think about that thing that just you've been doing it too long. What's that thing in your life? God said, y'all been doing this too long. Y'all have been going around the mountain. You've been on the mountain all this time. You've been on this mountain for years. The children of Israel, 40 years wandering. God said, do me a favor. You've been on this. You've been in this. I just came back. You still washing dishes. I came back 3 hours. You still washing dishes? You still doing your homework? What kind of homework you got? That's 10 hours. You still doing the same thing. The word of God says that there's an area in your life. You've been on it too long. It don't take that long to get financially free. It don't take that long to get your credit score up. It don't take that long to get your credit score up. It don't take that long to fix that thing in your marriage. It don't take that long, Father, to get right with your daughter. It don't take that long to get right with your son. It don't take that long. God says you have compassed this mouth long enough. Long enough. Your banker, you've been living from check to check long enough. You've been faking it and putting on the front long enough. Watch what he says. He said, turn. He said, turn. That's it. He said, turn, son. That's all I need you to do. You've been doing this. Now I need you to do me a favor, son. Just turn. Just turn. And don't just turn. Oh, I got 3-4 slides for you. Don't just turn. He said, when you turn, turn northward. Go ahead, DJ. Can I get that? He said, turn northward. And northward is what? Come on, northward is what? Come on, talk to me, DJ. Yeah, come on, all the way. 2019, if you feeling it, come on. 2019, we going all the way up. We going where God, nothing's gonna stop us. We going all the way up, y'all. We all the way up. Come on, 2019. Come on, 2019, y'all. Thank you, DJ. Watch this. 2019, your relationship's going all the way up. 2019, your finance is going all the way up. 2019, your health is going, oh, come on, somebody. Your health is going all the way up. Your relationship's going all the way up. And nothing can stop you. You're the only one that can stop you. So we're going to get to these slides. God told me to tell you how this is going to happen. Oh, I'm so excited for you. Can y'all do me a favor? When you blow up, though, don't stop coming to spiritual development. For real, because I feel some of y'all about to go blow up, and y'all gonna be like, "He coming when and where?" Oh, I'm good on that. Like for real, when you broke now, you going through it right now, you here. Some of y'all gonna blow up and be like, "I'm good. I don't need God no more. I got what I wanted." Don't do that. Don't do it. When you blow up, I need you to do me a favor. When you blow up, get your butt back here and bring somebody and say it worked. For real, he told me what the Lord said in 2018. I finished that. I'm gonna need you to be real. Some of this stuff's gonna hurt today, but it's okay. One of the things I'm starting to realize is there's a small group of people that's really living the American dream. So they're selling you some good information. They're not showing you how to execute on those. All I'm saying is, as we move forward, we can't help certain things, but we're not gonna sabotage ourselves. I'm gonna show you why they execute and why you don't. But more of us could be living whatever life we want. But what they didn't show you is how you were supposed to do that. What I want y'all to start doing for me is having dreams and then give me a couple nightmares to go with the dream. For real, I just want you to make up in your mind like this could happen. Not because I want you to be spooked out, but I don't want you to get hit and you like, I didn't prepare for that.